Hello, my students. I am Ardhindu De and you are watching Eddie's English Literature. Today, we are trying to understand the role and function of Adolphus Cusins in George Bernard Shaw's play Major Barbara. It is very interesting to note how the Greek professor, the classical scholar Adolphus Cusins, agrees to join Undershaft's gunpowder business. Why does Shaw mark his play that way? But first of all, a few words on George Bernard Shaw. Irish-born British dramatist, literary critic and novelist George Bernard Shaw is known for using comedy to expose social evils and exploring philosophical ideas in his plays. Remember, he wrote astute criticism of the arts and maintained extensive correspondence with many of the other public figures of his time. Like so many artists, he too struggled to establish a literary career and joined the Fabian Society, a middle-class socialist group committed to transformation of English government and society. Shaw wrote more than 50 plays during his lifetime. In 1893, published his first play, Widower's Houses, which he described as an unpleasant play. From 1895 to 1898, worked for the Saturday Review as a dramatic critic. In 1894, published the two-volume play, Pleasant and Unpleasant, which included Mrs. Warren's Profession, Candida, Arms and the Man, The Man of Destiny, and The Philanderer. In 1901, published three plays for Puritans, a collection that included The Devil's Disciple, Caesar and Cleopatra, and Captain Brassbound's Conversion. In 1903, published the play Man and Superman. In 1905, his satirical play Major Barbara was also performed. In 1913, his comedic play Pygmalion was performed. In 1921, published Back to Methuselah, a series of five related plays. In 1923, Saint Joan, a depiction of French heroine Joan of Arc, was performed. In 1925, won the Nobel Prize in Literature. Although Shaw accepted the Nobel Prize in Literature, he refused the prize money, arranging instead for the money to go toward funding the translation of Swedish literature into English. Strange in characterization, being mysteriously aloof from the action, yet in action, an observer and a choric commentator on the religious conflict between Undershaft and Barbara, and finally has chosen a future Undershaft. Role and function of Adolphus Cusins in the Sevian play Major Barbara is complex and difficult to ascertain. As you all know, Shaw's play are complex in ideas. Cusins has been introduced as a spectacled student, slightly thin-haired and sweet-voiced professor of Greek. His sense of humor, right, Shaw, is intellectual and subtle. He is the most implacable, determined, tenacious, intolerant person, capable possibly of murder, but not of cruelty and crassness, by operation of some instinct which is not merciful enough to blind him with the illusions of love. He is obstinately bent on marrying Barbara. In Major Barbara, Shaw questions the morality that dismisses the principles and practices of a munitions manufacturer while applauding the members and benefactors of the Salvation Army. By the end of the play, Barbara, a major in the Salvation Army, has realized that the organization's solutions are inadequate and the power of the industrialist Undershaft must be confronted and redirected. As he puts it, here is no wicked side. Life is all one. Ideas of power and social intervention fascinated Shaw, and the action of Major Barbara pivots around the recommendation that society cannot be saved until either the professors of Greek take the making gunpowder or else makers of gunpowder become professors of Greek. The former happens in the play. When the classical scholar Adolphus Cusins agrees to join Undershaft's business. This professor of Greek, nicknamed as Euripides for his ironic pessimism and pity and modeled on the famous Professor Gilbert Murray, Shaw's personal friend, Greek scholar and transcriber, as we all know, employed in Oxford, is introduced into the core of the action of the Major Barbara, not to propagate the high refinement and noble philosophy of Greek learning, but to suggest a crucial point, of view in the Sevian thesis. The point that Shaw wants to suggest is that it is through a merger of intellectual power and the power of money that real salvation can be achieved. Salvation cannot be truly attained through religious institutions, notwithstanding their piety and sincerity, for religious institutions exist by selling themselves to the rich. Cusins himself is aware of his privileged position in society as a consequence of his mastery of Greek. He tells Undershaft, Greek scholars are privileged men. Their position is unchangeable. Other languages are the qualifications of waiters and commercial travelers. Greek is to a man of position what the hallmark is to silver. So, Undershaft too is aware of Cusins' intellectual superiority, and that is possibly the most significant reason behind his choice of Cusins as his heir. It is precisely because of this that Undershaft quotes Plato, reminding Cusins. Plato says that society cannot be saved until either the professor of Greek take to making gunpowder. So, in a diplomatic way, Undershaft suggests to Cusins that the real freedom and will of the people of the world would only be realized if intellectually gifted professors like Adolphus Cusins and hard-boiled businessmen like Undershaft will shake hands. And shake hands with intellectual power and practical wisdom. Shaw suggests that Cusins will never succeed by teaching a dead language, the Greek, and preaching an absolute philosophy that the Greeks practiced. Only a marriage of Cusins' knowledge of Greek and the power of money can make him benefited to society. That is why Cusins is ready to accept the inheritance of the Undershaft. And he does not merely sell his soul for money. Whatever he does is for the larger benefit of the world. So there is a message that Shaw wants to deliver here. And this is evident from Cusins' explanatory statement to Barbara towards the end of the play. as a teacher of Greek. I have the intellectual man weapons against the common man. I now want to give the common man weapons against the intellectual man. I want a power simple enough for common man to use, yet strong enough to force the intellectual obligate to use its genius for the general good. Cusins had long realized the truth much before he met Undershaft and Barbara, and this is evident when he tells Barbara that this parting gift to one of his students who went to war was not a copy of Plato's Republic, but a revolver and a 100 Undershaft cartridge. That act committed me to that place forever. Cusins is a practical man, and never, unlike Barbara of the first stage of the play, yields to the utopia of high ideas and revolutionary dreams. It is his absolute dedication to the practical reality that he even accepts Undershaft's proposal in spite of the possibility of Barbara revolting against him. It is precisely because of this dedication to reality that when at the end of the second act, does not make his aggrieved beloved trying to console her, but takes up the drum and follows the procession of the army with bold enthusiasm. Not that Cusins is casual in his approach to Barbara. On the contrary, he is madly in love with her, and the Greek scholar is determined to marry Barbara at all costs. Had it not been for Barbara, Cusins would never have joined the army. However, Cusins uses the army much like he does his drum, considering it as an instrument for his Dionysian ecstasies. But he never confuses his love with his ultimate aim of braving the practical truth. Cusins' dream comes true when Barbara approves his final decision and also takes up her father's challenge to convert the well-fed, well-clothed, materially satisfied people in Undershaft's colony. It must be mentioned that Cusins, with his sheer self-control and ready wit, always has his own way by sheer determination. His confidence and business instinct are best evident in the bargain scene. The moment he realizes that Undershaft needs him, he raises his price and establishes his own terms and conditions. No doubt, his shrewd Greek scholar is the third protagonist of the play, apart from Undershaft and Barbara. But witty, ironic, sensitive, talkative, he, as Margaret Morgan points out, as a chorus, comments upon and interprets the actions and ideas of Undershaft and Barbara. So that's all for today's class. I think you have got a little bit of idea of Adolphus Cusins and the personality that creates or shapes the drama of Major Barbara into a new light, into a new ideals. Now, so has served his purpose, but you have to prove that you have understood this by taking a character sketch of that Adolphus Cusins, the Greek professor, in your notebook and make a study by deciphering all the meaningful words that he uttered in his speech. So, like, share, comment, and obviously subscribe to my channel to get this kind of post And if you have any question, just ask me. I will try my best to give some answers. So bye-bye. Thank you.